My name's John Farnworth, football freestyler from Preston in the UK. I've won world and European titles through football freestyle, and I also currently hold 4 Guinness World Records. I got into freestyle in 2003 actually, and I didn't really know much about it. I didn't know what it was, and I went to an event in Manchester through Nike, like a Nike football freestyle contest. And I went along not knowing what was going to go, and I thought I'd go and watch, and I just saw these amazing tricks and skills that I thought weren't possible. I thought, you know, it was camera trickery. That inspired me to start, and then from then on I got really interested in it, and I practiced every day until I could do these tricks that I seen. And then once I did that, I started to try and make my own almost my own tricks, my own movements and things through that. There's no rules, which I think is great, because if you put rules on things, it can be almost, can stay the same, it doesn't evolve, whereas freestyle is always evolving, and myself, I'm always trying to improve. And I think the fact that there is no, you know, right or wrong, there's no coaches, there's no, you know, no one saying it's right or wrong, which is the best thing about it. The thing about it being expressive, I think every freestyler should be different, because no two people in the world are the same. And I think freestyle should bring out your personality. Like, a lot of my family, when they see my shows, they tend to watch the people and say how the joy it brings them, which is nice. So I think, yeah, if it expresses your personality, how you are outside of freestyle, then it becomes your life. I never watch freestylers, I watch other people, I watch parkour athletes, I watch even skateboarders. What they do with that board, I always think, can I do that with a football? You know, what they've done over that pole, can I do that and put a football into it? That's what I think. I always try and think outside the box. So if something's not been done, I like to be able to try and make that possible. That's what I enjoy. I've been so lucky. I've probably travelled to nearly 30 countries, which is amazing, in 4 or 5 years. But I've performed, I mean, I've performed for the Saudi Arabian royal family, which was amazing. But I've done shows at beach soccer events, which is quite hard because it's on sand. So it took me a while to get used to it, because the sand always was in my eyes and things like that. I'm always thinking, like, even looking at the road, I'm like, could I bounce the ball off that curb? Could I, you know, could I stand on that pole and just juggle a ball? Could I get high in the air and do it? And just things that probably normal people don't think about. So I think that's why I do enjoy it so much, because I'm always thinking. And if I'm not thinking about where I'm performing, I'm always thinking about what tricks I could do next, what I could try. So I usually write it down on a sheet of paper or in my phone, just make a note. And then next time I'm practicing, I'll go and try it and make it possible. When it started, it was a hobby, you know, I did it for fun, and that kind of evolved into a passion. Like, it's something, like, a lot of people say, oh, do you do anything else but freestyle? And it's kind of sad, but I don't, like, you know, I used to, like, but now I never get bored of it. And I think if you can do that and never get bored of something, I mean, you're gonna go through good and bad days. I think if someone didn't, I think it'd be wrong, but I think it, on the whole, there's always something to go for, and whether it's the marathon, whether it's another challenge, or it's a world record, whether it's just one trick, it's all the same, it's all something to head for, really.